So the process that I actually have for importing footage from a wedding and making sure that it's backed up and then that it's ready to be in fulfillment once I actually am ready to edit it is not very difficult, but it is very organized. And I think it's very important to be extremely organized and to know where footage is, to know where footage is being backed up, to know where the original footage is versus the edited footage. So I just want to quickly walk you through how I do things. I won't show you the entire import process in the, you know, the actual status bar. I'll just skip forward in those sections, but it'll give you a really good idea as far as what I do and why I think that it works really well for the work that I do. But basically, my storage solution and my storage workflow is fairly simple, but it's pretty advanced in the same form. So let me quickly show you that first.
So at the heart of the setup and the backbone of the entire setup is this Drobo. And the Drobo is basically a 20 terabyte RAID storage device that is designed to basically store and back up all my footage. So I do not edit off of this drive, but this is where I store everything and where it's very important to keep everything. And inside that drive are basically 5 4-terabyte drives, making 20 terabytes total and giving me plenty of storage space. On the top of my desk, I have more of what are considered the actual working drives as far as what I work off of. My main drive that I actually do all editing off of is this Samsung 1 terabyte SSD drive. It is extremely fast, and that is what I basically, any job that I'm currently working on is always being edited off of this drive. Bus powered, super small, super fast, and that's what I work off of. And then these drives over here, which are G drives, they're 4 terabytes a piece. These are basically two things. Number one, they are a mirror image of this drive at all times. Therefore, I always can, on a per hour, per day basis, I can always go back to an original state of this drive. If for some reason something happens to, I don't lose any footage. But because they have 4 terabytes and this is only one, these are also where all the current projects that are in fulfillment, meaning they're ready to be edited, that's where these live. And so this stuff is backed up on the Drobo first, then it's brought to here into the fulfillment drives. This is basically just a mirror copy of this. And then once it's actually ready to be edited, it is transferred over to here and I actually edit the project. And then once it's all done being edited, the final project goes back to the Drobo and it's deleted from these drives. So it's in full backup 4 different times when I'm actually working on a project. And then it's stored on a RAID system, which is very secure and very, I like to say reliable, all the other times.
One of the very first and most important things for me is to just get the footage off the SD cards onto the Drobo in their original state and have those there so that they are completely imported. I never ever work on a new project with any of my cameras on an SD card that has previous footage on it. Regardless if I have tons of space left on it or not, I like to start every project formatting the drives and the SDs, just making sure that they're completely clean, and when I import them, knowing that they are just one project. Because there's been times that I've got in the past that I have gotten to a job and I run out of space, and then I don't know if I can delete things on the SD cards because I'm not sure if I already imported them. So my process now is that I import everything, back everything up immediately on the drives, and I don't have to worry about whether I did that already. And when I go to a new project, I always just format the drives. I know that they're good to go. So first things first, on my Drobo, I have things backed up and sorted by years. So 2017 weddings. These are basically the 4 weddings I've done already this year. I basically create a new folder right away. I label it what the couple's name is and the date, 5/6/17. I label that with my tag. I open it. Inside there, I create basically three folders. Footage original, audio original, and completed films. Once I do that, I'm basically ready for the import process, and that's where my Lexar workflow little setup that I have here is how I import everything. So here's the process.
Basically, these are all SD cards from this past weekend's wedding. All the ones that are 128 gigs a piece are all from cameras, and then these little tiny micro SD cards are from the portable little Tascam audio recorders I use, and then this one's from the H6 for that. And then there's an additional one that's also already plugged in from the drone and from GoPros. That's just an additional micro SD, and that's already in. This workflow thing helps me tremendously.
because what it allows me to do is plug in all my SD cards at once. And all my micro SD cards go in this slot. So once those are all plugged in, they basically all are on my desktop now, as you see. So I have the two DR10Ls, which are the Tascam little lav recorders that I put on the groom and the officiant. And then the four additional drives you see here are basically the other drives. So it's three cameras, three main cameras, which are two A7S2s, one A6500, and then the additional one is usually my little handheld RX100 Mark V. I don't really use it on a wedding day specifically for anything really important, but I do use it every once in a while for just a quick, if I need to capture footage really quickly and I don't have my cameras nearby, I can just capture that real quick. Nice thing about the Sonys is that the picture profiles are the same, and it actually does a pretty darn good job of getting me footage sometimes if I'm on a really tight lens and I need to use something wider, so whatever. So basically, I go to the DR10Ls. I know that one of these is the officiant and one of these is the groom, so I basically will listen to it.
This is groom ceremony lav.
As you hear, I always start on the recording with what it is. That way I can just really quickly listen instead of having to fast forward and try to figure out what it is. So you heard me just say, this is groom ceremony lav. And then that way, that's what I label it. So I label it ceremony groom lav and the date 5/6/17. I label this original. Then I actually take that same name for the other one. I make the Tascam record a backup as well. And I simply copy these and paste them into that folder. I go to the other Tascam and I label that one ceremony officiant lav 5/6/17. And I label the other one the same thing, but backup. And I copy that into the audio drive. So after I import those, the next thing I import is the H6 SD. So the H6 is what I use basically for the DJ, tapping into the DJ for things like the ceremony, which normally I don't do because my lavs are fine, but I will tap into it for speeches and offer all those other things. So I usually have two files, and one of them is usually the speeches. And I'll just copy these over to the audio folder. I don't have to label them right now. I know that the Zoom comes from the Zoom H6, so it's pretty easy for me to know what that is. It's just a matter of figuring out which file is which once I actually bring it into Final Cut, which is fine. So then I eject the audio things just to make sure that I remember that I already backed them up. Then I'm basically left with four SD cards, and each one of them I know is a camera. Now Sony obviously does things in like folders and folders and folders worth of things. So inside the M4 root folder is the clips folder, and inside the clips folder is basically where I know that the footage is. So once I open that up and I look in clips, I sort it by kind, just so that it puts all the video files in a row rather than all the XML files that are down below. I open up the first clip and I can very quickly tell what it is. This is the behind the scenes vlog camera. And not that the footage is very important on this, but because I got a few things from it on the actual, during the ceremony, I got a few things that maybe might be useful for me, I will actually just import those. So here's what I do right away. Instead of keeping these all C0001, C0002, since all the cameras are always gonna be that way because I format them each time, they're always gonna have the same files, I don't want four files that say the same thing. So I right away highlight all the files, and the easy quick thing on a Mac is if you right click on it and just type rename, you can rename with a certain format and then it will just number them following each one. So I will name this RX105 underscore, and it will start at number one and then click rename. And as you see, it just renames every single one of them to be RX100 with the names following it. I'd much rather do that because I want to know, number one, what camera it is. And more importantly, I want to know that it's not C0000001. Okay, so I do that. That's all importing now. I go to the next SD card. Do the same thing, sort by kind. I look at the first clip. This one I know is camera two because it's the groom prep. The other one we had running for the bride prep. So I'll rename this A7S2 underscore. Now I have two A7S2s, but you'll see that I'll label one A7S1, one A7S2. It's more just for the sake of camera one versus camera two, which realistically doesn't matter because the footage is all equally as important. It just helps me to kind of have an organizational sake. So I'll copy those in there. Clip, sort by kind. I know that this now is camera one because the dress is first. Usually the first thing I shoot during the day is the dress. I'll rename this A7S1 underscore. It'll rename all this footage. I'll select it all, I'll copy it, I'll paste it in that folder, and I have one more, which is gonna be the A6500. The A6500, ultimately, I only use for one main thing, and that is the ceremony. So sometimes I'll use it for more than that, but for the most part, it's just one thing. So I know that this is A6500, and it's only one file, which makes it really easy. So I copy that into there. So now you can see that there's four different things copying, and these are all copying right to the Drobo. So the Drobo, like I said, is the first main place that I put everything, and then I start to import things actually into the Final Cut file library system onto the other drives, the SSD and the G drives. So the Drobo, just first of all, I get it right on there, I store it there, and then I put it in other places to actually work on it. So that's the process first. So I will just let these things finish, and then we will catch up in 1 second, just about this quick. So now that the footage is all imported, I just basically quickly look through and make sure that I have all the cameras. So RX100, A6500, A7S2, A7S1, and then in the audio, I make sure the audio is there, which there should be ceremony groom lav, ceremony officiant lav, and then the H6 for those. So that is basically the first step of the process. Then I know everything is imported and on the actual Drobo. Now I do the next step, which is actually importing this stuff into Final Cut. So now that it's imported, I basically eject everything from my actual desktop to make sure that I know that obviously it's all imported at this point. So then I open up Final Cut Pro and I go File, New, Library. And I'm gonna put the library on the main G drive. So number one G drive. I'm not putting it on the SSD right now because I'm not actually going to be editing this yet. This is gonna be in fulfillment, so it'll be edited in the next couple of weeks, but I import it all and get it all into Final Cut on that drive, which then is backed up by the other G drive. So already it's in three places and I have lots of safety in what that is. And all the other files, so the original files, the actual main .mp4 files in their original format live on the Drobo. And then the Final Cut projects, which actually have all the audio and the footage as well, live on all the other drives. So those are all editable files, where the other ones are on the Drobo are just the main. So I create a new project. I label it the exact same thing as I did the previous one. So Jordan and Samantha, even though this, I just put May 2017 because it doesn't let me do the slashes for the date. So then I see the project is created. I go to import media. I go to the Drobo, years, 2017, weddings, and the thing that I just created. I first just import all the audio, and I will label this dialogue. Very important here to make sure that you always copy to library. I want to make sure that the actual files copy to the library and they don't stay in place in the Drobo, or else I'm not really backing it up. I will import all. Now I like to really use the names of the roles, so I don't want dialogue. And unfortunately, I wish you could save roles on a per Final Cut basis rather than just per project, but for some reason it doesn't let you do that. So I will edit right away, go to assign audio roles. I will make an audio role that is called external audio because these are all external audio sources. They are not the actual audio sources from the camera. And then I will assign these audio external audio. So these are all imported now in Final Cut, and you see that they're orange. It's because I labeled them, assigned them a role of external audio. I like them to be really easy for me to spot so I can know when I import all the other stuff, this is actually the edited external audio rather than just the internal camera audio. Also, I have a workspace here that is called Assembly Laptop. Right now I'm working off my laptop just because I'm recording the screen, but normally I work off dual monitors. So then I go to Import. I go to that same folder on the Drobo, Footage Original. I do Command A to highlight everything, 430 clips. I assign the role, dialogue is fine, automatically would also do dialogue, so that's fine. Copy to Library, I wanna do that. That's good. Import all. So while all this is importing, figured what I'd quickly talk about is just the editing program I use. I use Final Cut Pro 10, and there are a lot of people that go back and forth between which is better, Final Cut 10 versus Premiere. I'm doing entirely separate videos on why I use Final Cut Pro and why I don't use Premiere for weddings. I love Adobe Premiere, and I think it's a powerful program. There are just so many things that I think Final Cut does so much better for weddings. Or more importantly, for large projects that have as many clips as a wedding does. As a wedding, I typically have anywhere between 400 to 600 or 700 clips on a wedding, and there is just nothing as good as Final Cut as far as organization is concerned, which I'll show you a little bit more about in the next process, but want to take that time to at least let you know. That's what I use. Doesn't mean you can't use Premiere. Doesn't mean that Premiere can't get you in exactly the same film. Premiere actually does things a little bit better than Final Cut in some aspects, but that's just what I use. I'll walk through the process of why, and that'll be another whole video, but I'm gonna let this stuff import and we'll catch back up in 1 second. So the next step in the process, I'm not gonna walk you through in this video. This video, primarily, I just wanted to walk you through how I import things, how I back things up, and what my overall file workflow is. I'm gonna be doing a whole other video that talks about how I now take the time when I go into the project and I start to favorite things and I start to label things and keyword things. Incredibly useful for organizing and editing wedding films. I'm gonna do a whole separate video on that. This one, primarily, I just wanted to show you how I import things and how I label things. And most importantly, hopefully what you saw is the fact that it's very important to back things up. I have things on a Drobo, two other current hard drives, and then an actual drive that I'm editing off of, so things are backed up four different times. I cannot stress the importance of backing things up. No matter how reliable any drive you ever think you have is, there's never a drive that is 100% fail-proof. So it's good to just basically back things up. Use ChronoSync, use programs like that to back things up, and it will definitely benefit you in the long run. But that's kind of my import process, and I encourage you to subscribe to this YouTube channel, and you can see a little bit more about how I actually keyword things and favorite things, which to me is the number one feature of why Final Cut is such a great program for organizing a lot of clips. So stay tuned for that, but thanks for joining me on just this quick import process, and see you in the next video.